It seems like every day there's yet another frothy cryptocurrency in the news making people rich. Today, we're going to talk about one of the most important but low-profile niches of crypto, stablecoins. Stablecoins aren't going to make people rich, but they are arguably some of the most important cryptocurrency projects out there. So important that governments, central banks, and large institutions like Facebook, Visa, and JP Morgan are all considering adopting them or creating their own. So, what's all the hype about? Why are these coins important? How do they work? What do governments, banks, and tech companies plan to do with them? Let's dive in. Presumably, you've heard of cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and Ethereum. If not, you can watch our videos linked above to learn about them. While there are many things to love about Bitcoin, it's not ideal as a currency. Although it was initially designed to be a currency, the fees were far too high, and the transactions were too slow for day-to-day transactions. It's impractical to wait 10 minutes or pay $10 in fees to buy a cup of coffee. The Lightning Network fixed these problems, but there's still one big problem that makes Bitcoin a poor day-to-day currency. It's volatility. Think about it. A single tweet from Elon can send Bitcoin to the moon or to the dumpster. This greatly impacts its ability to act as a reliable unit of account and makes it a poor choice for a day-to-day currency. But there are a lot of benefits of cryptocurrencies that Bitcoin introduced to the world. Fast, cheap settlements without middlemen, decentralization, control of one's assets, and a global monetary system that is native to the internet, to name a few. Now imagine if we could have all of those without the volatility. Enter stablecoins. But first, subscribe to our channel if you want to keep up to date with the latest innovations in the crypto industry. And if you want to start buying Bitcoin or Ethereum, then sign up for Coinbase using the link in the description below and you'll get $10 worth of crypto for free. Stablecoins are the most obvious solution to the volatility problem. Stablecoin has the same benefits of a cryptocurrency like Bitcoin, but with one key difference. Its value is pegged to another currency, like the US dollar or the British pound. This combines the benefits of cryptocurrency with the pricing stability of a fiat currency like the US dollar. Since the goods and services we consume are still priced in dollars, this makes stablecoins a much more practical currency. Stablecoins can be decentralized like Tether and USDC, or decentralized and algorithmic like DAI and Terra UST. Let's take a look at a popular, although controversial, stablecoin, Tether. Tether, the first stablecoin project ever, was initially launched as a coin called Realcoin back in 2014. In theory, every Tether coin or USDT is backed by an equivalent amount of assets like dollars, euros, or bonds. This should ensure that people can always convert their Tether back to dollars if they choose to. Although there's a lot of controversy about whether Tether maintains the correct amount of backing. Many consider this to be one of the greatest risks in the cryptocurrency space, but that's a topic for another video. While some stablecoins, like Tether, maintain their peg value by keeping an equivalent amount of non-crypto assets, others, like Terra UST, use an algorithmic approach to maintain their peg, relying on arbitrages to bring the stablecoin value back to its peg in case it ever deviates too much. Facebook, now called Meta, is trying to enter the space too. They were planning to launch their own stablecoin called Diem, but that plan is now on hold. Meta's mission is to connect the world and erase borders. A plan of this vision is to make it just as easy for people to transfer money as it is for them to share photos or messages. Now, stablecoins really have only one important job, to maintain their pegged value. But that's easier said than done. These stablecoin projects are relatively new and haven't had the time to be battle-tested, and as a result, there are a lot of potential problems and risks. Tether, for example, has been under a lot of scrutiny in the past because they were not able to prove that they had the assets to back up all the Tether in circulation. This can shake confidence in the stablecoin and affect its value. At one point in 2018, the price even fell by 15%, bringing the price down to 85 cents. Not quite the stability one would expect from a stablecoin, huh? But for all the controversy around stablecoins, there is a massive and inevitable wave of adoption that has been set in motion by financial institutions. When you can settle large transactions for a fraction of the cost of traditional methods, earn much greater interest, and access a whole new financial market, you can be sure that the large banks and payment processors aren't sleeping on this wave of innovation. But even banks and payment processors are small fries compared to some of the players looking to start using stablecoins. Central banks, China for example, recently came out with a digital version of its own currency, giving it a new level of control over its economy. That's a topic for another video though. Be sure to subscribe. Stablecoins aren't the cryptocurrencies that get all the attention, but they are some of the most important, attracting massive waves of capital and the innovation that comes along with it. If you like this video, then please drop us a like and share the video, as it really helps the channel out. If you are enjoying learning about cryptocurrencies, then be sure to subscribe for more Lightbulb moments like this. Cheers.